Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to our worship service. We are glad to have you here. And sorry I couldn't be here last Sunday, but you wouldn't have wanted me here. Really. But we are glad to be back this year and for our first live service of 2021. So Happy New Year. Do we have any announcements to share this morning?
Pastor?
Yeah?
Mobile Food Bank is Wednesday.
Okay.
At the fairgrounds from 4:30 to 6. If it's open to all, you know, there's no rules. You just have to give us your name and phone number and how many are in your family. But or if you know, if you have neighbors, friends, relatives, that could use a little help. We are going to be at the fairgrounds Wednesday. It's a drive-thru, so it's no contact. You just pull up and you put the food in your car and you drive off. So anybody knows of anyone that could use some help or could use some extra, we can glad to have.
Yep, send them out.
Excuse me?
I said send.
What time is it? 4:30 to 6.
And our bread and cup are on the back table rather than passing it out to you. What?
It's gluten free.
Yes, it's gluten free. We decided just do gluten free. It's good for all of us. So, okay, yes.
I just wanted to say I was surprised this last weekend by family and friends, and several folks had sent cards for my retirement, and I just wanted to say thank you all for the cards that were sent, and this is just an acknowledgement. I'll be sending a thank you in the mail to you. Thank you very much.
I have a honey-do list for him. Okay, let us turn our hearts and minds to God. Stand if you can and join me in our call to worship. Now note, this first thing calls you for clap enthusiastically. A new day has begun. Are you ready to give God's praise?
We are ready.
Are you ready to leave behind the baggage? Are you ready to step out in faith?
We are ready.
Are you ready to forgive even the one that hurt you the most?
We are ready.
Are you ready to release your doubts and fears?
We are ready.
Oh Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. We are yours and we are ready. Let us come together in our prayers of confession and brokenness. As we gather our thoughts into the quietness and we confess our sins to the one who knows best, we know ourselves chosen, adopted as children of God. We dare to believe that you and I are part of a plan, conceived before the foundations of the universe. But we are living, or are we living as God's children? Are we honoring that inheritance? We know ourselves called, but we are easily distracted. We know ourselves loved, but we balk at the cost. And so I do invite you to come and confess your sins to God. Our God has poured out grace upon grace, freely in great abundance, on you and even on me. Though we have never earned it, and we don't deserve it. In Christ we are made new through his blood, all of our sins and things crumble away. In Christ we are forgiven. We are signed with the Spirit. We are lavished with gift upon gift. And we are released into hope to live for praise and for glory. Amen.
This is the word of the Lord from Ephesians 1, 3 through 14. How blessed is God, and what a blessing he is. He is the Father of our Master, Jesus Christ, and takes us to the high places of blessing in him. Long before he laid down earth's foundations, he has in mind, settled on us as the focus of his love, to be made whole and holy by his love. Long, long ago, he decided to adopt us into his family through Jesus Christ. What pleasure he took in this planning of this. He wanted us to enter into the celebration of his lavish gift giving by the hand of his beloved Son. Because of the sacrifice of the Messiah, his blood poured out of the altar of the cross, we're free people, free of the penalties and punishments chalked up by all of our misdeeds. And not just barely free, being free either. Abundantly free, he thought of everything, provided for everything we could possibly need, letting us in his plans he took such delight in the making. He set it all out of us before us in Christ, a long-range plan in which everything would be brought together and summed up in by him. Everything in deepest heavens, everything on planet on earth. It's in Christ that we find out who we are and what we are living for. Long before we first heard of Christ and got our hopes up, he had his eyes on us. He designed on us for glorious living, parts of all over the purpose he is working out in everything and everyone. It is in the Christ that you, once you heard the truth and believe it, this message of your salvation, found on yourselves a home free, signed, sealed, and delivered by the Holy Spirit. This signet from God is the first installment of what's coming, a reminder that we'll get everything God has planned for us, a praise and glorious life. John 1, 1 through 9, 10 through 18, an adaptation of John 1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was from God, and Word was God, and he was in the beginning with God. All knowledge came into being with him, and without him no knowledge was understood. What has come into being was life, and the life was the true enlightenment of all the people. The enlightenment illuminates in the dimness, and the ignorance and misery did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the enlightenment, so that all might be illuminated through him. He himself was not the illuminator, but he came to testify in the enlightenment. The illumined word was enlightened to everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into knowledge through him, yet the world did not understand him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he enlightened to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or the will of the man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have been enlightened by glory, that of the Father's only Son, shining with grace and truth. May God bless the reading of God's holy word.
In light of this week's darkness that occurred in our country, we reflect on the light that Jesus offers. Jesus points to the real purpose of our lives. We should want to turn away from hate and anger and look towards love and comfort of one another's hopes of making this a better place. However, as I watched with my mouth agape on Wednesday, that's not what I saw. What I should have witnessed was that the gifts we receive through Jesus Christ is an understanding that no matter our political persuasion, no matter our ethnicity, no matter our gender, no matter who we all have a place in God's realm. And that we need to be aware of and live into that understanding. We need to be aware that God doesn't stand us in a line and pick out who is and isn't worthy of being part of God's family. God's adopted all of us. And like any group of siblings, we need to figure out how to get along. Before God puts us in a permanent timeout, we're responsible for not letting the playground bully take advantage of our other siblings. We're responsible for calling out little brother and big sister when they are being brats and putting the lives of others in danger. And yes, each of us has our own opinion of what is and isn't acceptable. But truly, pulling them out, lining them up, and hanging them, even when said in jest, that's not okay. That's not okay. It's not acceptable behavior for God's children. Just as pointing a laser into the eye of someone, almost blinding them as they're standing at the entrance of an interstate to keep you from going out on that interstate and getting hit by an innocent motor vehicle or truck driver, just so you can prove your point that people who look like you are not being treated fairly. That's not okay. The delight God took or takes in us wasn't found in those kind of scenarios. The delight God finds in us when we take time to place our own, is when we take time to place our own opinions, our own egos aside and say, hey, shine a light for me on what you're feeling and what you're wanting. what I'm feeling and what I want. And then maybe we can shine a light on the problem and find a solution that's acceptable to not only us, but to God. There was so much wrong in what happened to cause the Black Lives Matter movement this last summer. And there was equally plenty wrong in what brought about last Wednesday. In each, the bottom line is that we have forgotten we are all God's children. And that when Jesus walked among us, he walked among all of us. Not any one political party, not any one ethnic group, not anyone's social status or country. And God expects us to do the same. God expects better of us. God demands better of us. And God has given us a new year and a light to lead us out of that darkness. And in 2021, it's our responsibility to follow. Amen. In prayer. Holy God, we each bring a long list of those for whom we pray for. We pray for ourselves. We pray for all those people who are on our prayer list. We pray for new ones that we add. We pray for folks like Justin and his family. We pray for people like Matthew and his family. Losing folks, especially in the holidays, is tough. Seems not to say it's tougher than other times, because it isn't, but it's tough. Losing those by accidents, by suicide, by COVID, by cancer, it's hard. And we ask you to help us. Help us to deal with it, and help us to find peace and comfort, knowing that you are there for us. And equally, we celebrate. We celebrate a new year. We celebrate retirement. We celebrate anniversaries and birthdays. We celebrate getting to go back to school and seeing our friends. We celebrate the fact that there's a vaccine that will hopefully help put an end to isolation. We ask you to be with all those who are struggling in this time with unemployment, with loss of homes, with war, with hunger. Show us how we can help, even in small ways. We thank you for our nation, even for its struggles, for its hard times and its good times. Help us to open our hearts to one another. And to you. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. As we leave behind a painful year and look with continued hope to the new year ahead, we need to remember to continue to give of what we have been given so that the light can shine out into the lives of others. The offering plates are on the back table. Remember that you can send in your gifts. You can send them electronically or through the mail with a check. So please continue to give. Join me in our prayer of dedication. Holy God and parent of us all, we have moved through this season of family and Christmas joy, and we are reminded that beyond our earthly families, you have adopted us into your redeemed family. Through the saving, redeeming work of the Incarnation, we have become heirs, and our redemption is a magnificent gift of salvation. We give our gifts, but we give ourselves as the only fitting response to your adoption of us, your rebellious children. Lead us in your way into this new year. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. As we gather, or had we gathered, I should say, had we gathered last week, we would have celebrated Holy Communion on Journey Sunday. It would have been the second Sunday after Christmas, 3 days after New Year's. And in the old song, the 12 days of Christmas, it would have been the ninth day, the day when the gift was nine people dancing. Even though this is a week later, you're still invited to come to this table. This table of the one star for following. This table of bread and cup for sharing. This table of three, now 10 days after the new year. And this table of at least four camels that are still traveling somewhere. And many, many hopes for the world. So come to this table. Even if you want to be laying everything down, because you are weary or fearful, isolated, or essential to everyone but you. Come to this table if you are swimming in Zoom or Facebook Live or virtual education or financial risk or grief. Come to this table if you are milked, if you have milked all of the joy of Christmas, enough to carry you into 2021. Or even if you don't have nearly enough. Come to this table if you have stopped dancing, even though you have many gifts to carry, or you need to be healed. Because by watching the dance, like a snowflake or an evergreen, or watching the dance in a friend or a stranger, watching the dance in an old story or on another path home, this warm bread and this sweet cup are to be shared right now. We remember in this new year, with the fearfulness of the pandemic and hope that it will be ended. Anybody for that? Yeah? Mm-hmm. Not only do we remember the journey of Magi, guided by the star, but all of the oases that they rested at. And the people they met, think of that, who lived in those places and shared their food with them on that journey. We remember a child born to change everything and the endangerment of many children. And we remember that the baby that was named Jesus, grew up to help people. Help people in their hurting and their loss. And traveled as many roads as we do. And taught with simple words. Words that we can understand. And told stories that we come back to so many times and find new meaning in when we do. At Passover, he blessed the unleavened bread. He poured wine and he poured out love freely. At Emmaus, he prayed and he broke the bread, but he sent it to us to find the cup in the world. Let us pray. Emmanuel, God, you are with us in our lonely nights, following so distant stars. We are carrying our old years and opening up our new ones, always hoping for an oasis for each of us and a blessing on earth in the form of bread in our hands and the cup we lift. I invite you to place your hands over your bread and your cup. May this bread and cup be so sacred we never lose the stars shine. Ignore a new year embedded in every day, or forget the Christ of the dance and the invitation to joy. This we pray as we join together in the prayer you taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The bread broken for you. Let us share the bread.
It is a gift that reminds us of our gifts.
The cup poured for you. Let us drink deeply. Join me in our prayer of thanksgiving. God, we thank you that when the star in the sky is gone, the kings and princes are home, the shepherds are back with their flocks, and we are tempted to pack the story away. This very bread and cup gives us the hope and courage to begin the true work of Christmas. Help us to find the lost, heal the broken, feed the hungry, release the prisoner, build the nations, bring peace among all, and make a heart music so that everyone can dance. Amen. Our next song, we do have music to it, but we don't all know it. So we're going to read it. Let us read together, Love Came Down at Christmas. Love came down at Christmas, love a lovely, love divine. Love was born at Christmas, stars and angels give the sign. Worship we the Godhead, love incarnate, love divine. Worship we our Jesus, what shall be our sacred sign? Love shall be our token, love be yours and love be mine. Love to God and neighbor. Love for prayer and gift and sign. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Let Christ's light shine in the darkest corners of your life. Let Christ's love shine in the darkest corners of the world. God is with us. Hallelujah. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve our Lord.